Welcome back, everyone. In this section, I'm going to show you how to use the DeepHub meeting. So first things first, let's get to it. So the first thing you'll see is the home page, which includes a time and date. Over here is the launcher, which will allow you to either join a meeting, start a meeting, schedule a meeting, or open the interactive whiteboard. Let's start a meeting. First, we click Instant Meeting. So for privacy reasons, I've already manually set the camera to be off. But if you look over here, you can see the basic settings for the camera. You can toggle the camera on or off, as well as the microphone and the speaker as well. I'm gonna turn that off as well. Over here, you can see the meeting ID number, the number of participants, and the time of the meeting. If we click it, we can see the participant management section. Over here is me, I'm the host. So I have all these options here. And then I also have a guest, one of my colleagues, Hansen. And I can do other things here, like if I want him to unmute his camera. Hey Hansen, you're on mute. Let me just give him a notification so he can either accept or reject it. And we're just gonna mute him anyway. Over on this section is the meeting management, which just gives you some other options. You can also access those through the host button right here as well. Now the record button allows you to record the meeting. Now if you're looking to find where your recorded meetings are, you can actually tap schedule right over here. This will also show you if there are any pre-scheduled meetings. If you go into history, you'll be able to see all of the different meetings, and right up here are the ones that have the recordings. Over here we have the screen share, so you can share your screen to the other participants. Let's cancel that for now. There's also a comments section. If you enable it, you'll be able to see the comments that the other participants put here, and if you don't want to see them, you can just disable it. If you hit more, you can get to the layout section. So it offers speaker, picture to picture, and evenly distributed. But I want to get to the interactive whiteboard. So let's check it out. So we're about to enter the interactive whiteboard, but what I want to show you is that you can actually hit hide, so you can still access the meeting and see everyone that you're in the meeting with. And then just click show again, and you're back at the meeting here at the interactive whiteboard, and you still have all of these functions from the DeepHub meeting while using the interactive whiteboard. So now let's take a look at the different functions that the interactive whiteboard has. Over here is the toolbar, which is equipped with several different types of tools for you to use, such as a text box, sticky notes, shapes, a line tool, a pen tool. You can also create your own mind maps, and there's also tables as well. So this is the toolbar side over here. Thank you, Sean, for your wonderful contribution. Let's move that out of the way. So next thing we're gonna use is the templates, which is right over here. All right, now the templates are these pre-made templates that you can use. You see over here you have research and analysis, diagramming, brainstorming, icebreakers. You can choose whichever one you want. I'm gonna go with, let's do a team meeting. So I'm gonna select this one here, hit use, and then I'm just gonna tap anywhere on the canvas. Cool. Now, one thing that's really awesome about this is that it's not just a picture or an image. This is actually interactable. It's the interactive whiteboard. So you can actually, you know, edit things like that. So right over here, right now, Sean is working on this section that says Gary. Oh, well, he changed it to Danny. Awesome. So what I'm gonna do right over here is, Sean, wait for me. Well, then I'll work over on Bianca. So while Sean is working on this section here, I'm gonna be focusing on this section here. And I can click this little feather here, and it's just gonna put some extra information right on this footer. So you can actually see the teams, the people, you know, who's doing what. You can also add tags. So let's say I'm like, okay, I want Sean to work on this one next. And so I'm gonna put a tag here. So anytime I have a tag with Sean's name on it, he knows that that's the one that he's gonna be working on. That's just one thing you can use tags for. All right, you can also do some reactions if you wanna like something. Oh, Sean, great work, I absolutely love it. You can do comments. All right, and you can also do annotation, which is gonna be right next to the comments one right here, annotation. So what's really fun, what I really love about this is if you do this thing over here and you select this little trumpet, you're gonna get the reactions button. And let's do the heart because it's super cute. Sean's already doing it. And I just think it's super fun. I could do this all day. So you can just do this to, you know, have fun, interact, react, things like that. Now, Sean, I am gonna kind of stop you for a second because I'm going to do the interactive demo. Now, right next to the reactions button is the interactive demo button. So that's gonna basically show what I see to everyone else. All right, so as of right now, they can't interact with it because I'm doing the demo for it. All right, at any time when I wanna stop, I just click the end button. All right, and now everyone can participate again. Now, if you can see here, Sean, there you are. Sean's a bit distracting right now, so I'm gonna click this button here just to toggle off his cursor so I can focus. But if I wanna see him again, I can toggle it back on. There he is. Right here is our timer section. So you can set a timer if you really want to. This is really good if you're doing some brainstorming sessions and you just need to consolidate that time into a specific area. You can also manually change it as well to get a specific time. I'm gonna click it to turn it off. Collapse it right over here. Now, the next thing I wanna show you guys is super cool. It's the AI assistant. Now, at the top bar here is the Q&A. So what you can do is just ask it any question. Let's see. All right, how to make a PowerPoint. And it's gonna come up with an answer for you. Great, now I know how to make a PowerPoint. It's very helpful for things when you need some inspiration or anything like that. I'm gonna go back because what you can also do is if you want it to help you like to create a PowerPoint or brainstorm ideas, you can also use this section over here. All right, you can also use it to generate mind maps. Let's take a look at that. Key points of writing a business plan, love it. Let's just use one that's already there. And what's gonna happen is that it's actually gonna generate a mind map for you about your prompt. This is not an image. This is stuff that you can interact with and edit. There's another part that I really wanna show you that I really like, and it's generate images, okay? So right over here, all right, you're just gonna put in a simple prompt because I don't know about you, but I'm horrible at drawing. And if I want my team to visualize something, this is really helpful. So let's say I want them to visualize a red car, okay? I just type in red car. There are different models that you can choose from as well, you know, photorealism, anime style, that's fun. I'm gonna stick with photorealism. All right, there's also additional style models, and I'm not gonna worry about that for now, but you know, it gives you a couple options depending on the model you chose. All right, and finally, let's say I already had like a picture of a car that I just wanted the AI image generator to like fix up for me. I could use that as a reference. So I'm gonna hit start, and we're gonna see what happens. Great, this is a lot better than anything I could have drawn, and it helps my team visualize what we're trying to work on. Now again, these are things that you can edit as well, all right? You can change the curvature of the border, and you can also change the size. All right, so maybe we're doing a business plan about red cars. Wonderful. Now I'm gonna exit out of this drawing mode by hitting the exit button right over here. Now I'm back at my interactive whiteboard. All right, so maybe my business plan is about red cars, all right? This is pretty much it. I think I've got all that I need for my meeting. I'm ready to end. So I'm gonna click right over here and hit the exit button. Now this exit button is just going to close the interactive whiteboard. And when I do that, everyone else involved with the whiteboard also is removed from the whiteboard as well. I still have my meeting going. I wanna end it, so I'm just gonna hang up. Goodbye, everyone. Thank you so much for your help. And this is the DeepHub meeting in a nutshell.